YouTube, Billy. So this morning, while I was sitting on the porcelain throne, scrolling through Twitter for a minute, came across a post about a man in Florida, not Florida man, but man in Florida, who was brutally beaten because... The story says, because he was wearing a DeSantis hat. Like, okay, there's got to be more to it. Well, some of the comments said, oh, this guy was a neo-Nazi, white supremacist. He deserved it. He's got a violent past. Blah, 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 blah. So that got me thinking even more. Have there been any other, you know, tragedies where... One side said, oh, you know, well, this guy had it coming because he's a violent criminal. You know, I thought about George Floyd. Thought about, you know, the three men that Kyle Rittenhouse shot. You know, there's... It is trying to see how to say this. Why can you not just be against violence? Can we agree on that? I'm against violence, okay? Period. Full stop. End of discussion. Violence is bad. And you know, the story goes, this guy in Florida was out canvassing a neighborhood, asking people to vote for Republicans. And they said, oh, you know, get your story straight, because I guess DeSantis had shared it. This dude is going ridiculously slow. And, you know, saying, oh, he just mouthed off to the wrong person, he had it coming. Well, no. Take away his alleged criminal past, and if you mouth off to anybody, does that, what's the word I'm looking for? Warrant you getting attacked and brutally beaten to the point where you're going to need facial reconstructive surgery? That's pretty bad. Whether or not anything will happen to the people who did this, I don't know. I didn't sit on the throne long enough to really do any in-depth research, and I've been busy at work all day. But, you know, think back to the summer of love, summer 2020, when riots were breaking out all over the country. Violence was everywhere. People were burning down businesses, burning up car lots, burning down, what are you doing? Burning down federal buildings, taking over entire city blocks, you know, saying, you know, we, whatever they called it, you know, police free zones. How can those people and how can those Democrats who fundraised to get them out of jail because of the violence that they unleashed. How is that justified? When you have peaceful protesters, peaceful anti-abortion protesters who are protesting, again, peacefully, outside of an abortion clinic, praying, and yet they get locked away for 11 years in prison. They get sentenced to 11 years. Why? How is that justified? And, you know, the left always uses January 6th. I'm sick of hearing January 6th, but hey, you know what? Let's use it, okay? The people who perpetuated violence that day deserve to be punished, deserve to be prosecuted. Sorry, I heard squealing tires. That kind of worried me. Okay, they broke the law. Now, that doesn't mean that their Fifth and Sixth Amendments should be forfeited and they get locked away for, let's say, a year and a half with no bail. Okay? They need to be a speedy trial. That is a constitutional right. When you had BLM rioters, Antifa rioters, nothing's gonna happen. FBI is not investigating them. It's the double standards that I'm sick of. And my stance is no violence. If you resort to violence, you are scum. You're worse than scum. So that's my stance now. Okay, January 6th people that committed violence, they deserve a speedy trial and to be punished for their crimes. The ones that committed actual acts of violence. Now, if you're one of the other, I don't know, tens of thousands of people, not just those few hundred, tens of thousands of people who were peaceful, just there to make their patriotic, peaceful voices heard, as President Trump said, no, you should not be investigated. You should not be prosecuted. Because that was within your constitutional rights. The right to assemble. The right to voice and air grievances against the government. You didn't have faith in the electoral process. You wanted to have answers, and answers were not forthcoming. So make your voices heard. That's the process. That's constitutionally protected free speech. Going to a city to loot and pillage and burn down businesses and destroy people's livelihoods, that is not constitutionally protected activity. So, violence good, peaceful protest, or sorry, no. Violence bad, peaceful protest good. As long as you stay peaceful. Now, the moment that, you know, you get that mob mentality and start creating violence, creating an unsafe environment, then no, I won't support that. It's just like, you know, Men in Black. I love the quote that Agent K said. A person is smart. And I don't remember the exact quote, but people are dumb, manipulative. Woohoo, I'm gonna go. Scared little beings, and you know it. Something like that. Please be excellent to each other. Tuba Billy, signing out. God be with you till we meet again.